हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. टिल नाउ वी स्टडीड मेनी क्रॉनिक डिजीजेस इन्वॉल्विंग इन्फेक्टिव नॉन इन्फेक्टिव, राइट. सो टुडे इन कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ दैट वी आर गोइंग टू द अदर टाइप ऑफ क्रॉनिक अल्सर्स लाइक इम्यून रिलेटेड. Where it is not more of infective part, it is more of inflammatory part. So there are some ulcers where you see in the peripheral part of the cornea. So where mainly the margin of the cornea is involved. So these type of ulcers are called as peripheral corneal ulcers or peripheral ulcerative keratitis or marginal keratolysis. So in this there are many varieties are there, many causes are these are mainly called as PUKs in short form. So the main causes are, it can be associated with the connective tissue disorders, Moran ulcers, rosacea keratitis, marginal keratitis, Terian marginal degeneration, pellucid marginal degeneration and cryptonular keratitis. So we are dealing one by one. The first of all, coming to the peripheral corneal ulcers associated with the connective tissue disorders. Okay. So these ulcers are mainly associated with connective tissue disorders like rheumatoid arthritis, systemic lupus erythematosus, polyarthritis nodosa or vaginal sclerodermatosis. So the main features of these ulcers are, they may start with unilateral and in later part of the time both eyes may be involved. So the multiple ulcers you can see in the periphery, and you see the inflammation adjacent to the limbus. Slowly that progress forming a gutter like thing or the thinning of the ulcer in the entire peripheral part of the cornea. So at the end of this stage, you see the somehow a contact lens is placed in the center of the cornea. So the peripheral part is thinned out, a gutter like thing is formed, and center part you can see it as a contact lens. So the further it may progress leading to the desmatocele, even the perforation. So it is always associated with the other systemic the diseases of connective tissue disorders. So how you treat such kind of disease? So in this picture you can make out the multiple peripheral ulcers with the adjacent limbus is completely congested. Okay, but there is no infiltration. You can see the ulcers are clear. There is no infiltrates or the slough material near around the corneal ulcers. Then how to treat these connective tissue disorder associated with the peripheral corneal ulcers? As usual, our topical medication with cycloplegics and the antibiotic with lot of lubrication is needed. But the topical steroids are used incautiously, not in final stage of the corneal ulcer. I mean in a very advanced stage of the corneal ulcer, because it further leads to the thinning of the cornea. And other systemic medication you have to use in the form of the immunosuppressants, corticosteroids or methotrexates orally, especially the cyclophosphamide, doxycycline and oral vitamin C to promote the healing of the stroma. In advanced stage where the topical treatment is not working, you can go for the surgical mode of treatment like the adjacent, the conjunctiva, which is congested, that is excised, so that the more of immunological components which are depositing in that area will be avoided. And you can use a supportive measures like bandage contact lens or the conjunctival flap can be used over that the ulcerative part for the impending perforation. And you can use the cyanocrylate glue adhesive for further perforation to avoid the further perforation. And in last stage you can go for peripheral tectonic keratoplasty. And the next very common peripheral corneal ulcer is the Mouren's ulcer. So the why it is more important, it is again a very severe inflammatory peripheral ulcerative keratitis. It is a autoimmune disease especially, and more of antibody against corneal epitheliums are produced and get deposited in the peripheral part of the cornea. It can be two type again. One is benign form and another one is the virulent form. So here mainly the as the antibodies are produced and get deposited, it leads to the ischemic necrosis and the vasculitis of the limbal vessels. And also there will be release of enzyme collagenase and proteoglycanase from the conjunctiva. That leads to the cornea. Okay, so the benign form, what I said, it is a unilateral and affects mainly the elderly people and it is slow in progression. Whereas the virulent type is very progressive and bilateral, seen in younger patients, and it is rapidly progressive, even the adjacent sclera involved. So the patient comes with the clinical features of a lot of pain, photophobia, lacrimation and diminish of vision. On examination you see some sort of gray infiltrates and very shallow ulcer, but it has a undermining ulcer. You can see the overhanging edge of that peripheral ulcer, whereas you can see the undermining ulcer, and it is progressing in a serpiginous manner. Okay, then the base is sometimes it is vascularized, and the spread may be self-limiting or it can be progressive. The adjacent conjunctiva is also a lot of congested, and sometimes ulcer may perforate also. So what is the mode of treatment? The treatment is you have to start with the corticosteroids every 2 to 3 hours. Okay, it is the initial therapy. And you have to go for the immunosuppressives like cyclosporine or other cytotoxic drugs. Then supportive measures like soft contact lens you can use. Then the other mode of treatment, the surgical, is lamellar or full thickness corneal grafts you can use. Okay. So the other things, as previously said, bandage contact lens you can use, corneal flap you can use, cyanoacrylate glue you can use to prevent the perforation of the cornea. So you can see the type of the corneal ulcer. The picture you can see there are the white infiltrates, and the entire peripheral part is involved, and there are the undermining edges in peripheral of the cornea. And slowly it starts at one part and may involve the entire cornea. Coming to the other type, that is the marginal catarrhal ulcer. It is a very superficial comparison to the other marginal ulcer. It is again situated at the limbus, more seen in the elderly people. And it is more of infectious condition because it is due to the hypersensitivity reaction to the staphylococcal toxins. So you see the patients with the chronic staphylococcal blepharoconjunctivitis or the blepharitis, in such type of patients you see the ulcers, especially if lid is involved. Yes, it is the superficial part of the cornea, marginal cornea is involved. Okay, so the other may be the Moraxella and Haemophilus also, the causative agents which causes this marginal catarrhal ulcer. The clinical features are again the same, the irritation, pain, photophobia and lot of watering will be there. On examination you can see, as I said, it is a very shallow ulcer, and you see the lot of infiltrations. Okay, peripheral, the other kind you see only the ulcer without infiltrations. Here you can see the infiltrations, which may be a single or the multiple, with staphylococcal conjunctivitis. Conjunctivitis in the form of lot of discharge, photophobia, the stickiness of eyelids will be there, watering will be there. Okay, the lot of lid edema will be there with the involvement of your the lymphatic nodules. So can make out with this the features the ulcer is present. You can call it as a marginal catarrhal ulcer. So the treatment is, yes, you have to treat the staphylococcal conjunctivitis with your the vigorous antibiotic therapy in the form of the drops as well as the antibiotic ointments in the night. And to reduce the inflammatory thing, yes, you have to go for the very mild corticosteroids with the low frequency. Then you have to treat the other adjacent underlying cause like blepharitis and chronic blepharitis conjunctivitis. Okay, so this is how the, you can see the pictures better in your books because these are very blurry, as such to say. Okay, so here you can make out the even the very severe conjunctival congestion with the matting of eyelashes is there, and some sort of discharge also you can make.